Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome your special guest referee, the World Heavyweight Champion, the Heartbreak Kid, Shawn Michaels.
Shawn Michaels involved in a great World Heavyweight title defense against Rob Van Dam here last week before it was interrupted by Triple H. But Michaels will be at Armageddon in less than 2 weeks in Fort Lauderdale, Florida on pay-per-view.
Yeah, but who will he face? Will it be Rob Van Dam or Triple H?
The following contest is set for one fall, and it is to determine the number one contender for the World Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, being accompanied by Ric Flair, from Greenwich, Connecticut, weighing in at 252 pounds, Triple H!
Triple H has to pin Rob Van Dam or make him submit. If the game gets disqualified for violating the rules, Rob Van Dam goes to Armageddon to meet Shawn Michaels for the World Heavyweight Championship.
Oh, that's right, Cole, but Shawn Michaels has to call this thing right down the middle. If he doesn't, he could be stripped of the title right here tonight.
And making his way to the ring, from Battle Creek, Michigan, weighing in at 235 pounds, Rob Van Dam!
It was 3 months ago tonight, on September 2nd, that Triple H was awarded the World Heavyweight Championship by Eric Bischoff. On that same night, Triple H lost a tag team match and was pinned by none other than Rob Van Dam. It could be fate, King.
Well, Rob Van Dam has been so close to being world champion on so many occasions, it's not even funny.
Back, I didn't think Shawn Michaels would ever return to WWE, but he came back at SummerSlam and beat Triple H in a street fight.
Yeah,
I never thought Shawn Michaels would get in the Elimination Chamber and fight for the World Heavyweight title, but he did. And I didn't think he could win it, but he believed and went on to become World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, what's your point, Cole?
Shawn Michaels has overcome so much, not just to return to the ring, but to become World Heavyweight Champion.
This could be huge!
The animosity between Triple H and Shawn Michaels is well documented. But let's not forget that Rob Van Dam was also in a huge collision with the Barricade. With a 180, Rob Van Dam, the reversal.
Oh, no. Wait a minute, Cole. What's he going to do here?
Playing mind games.
Yeah, a little intimidation there.
Triple H, one step ahead.
Look at these two jockey for position.
Watch it! Oh man, that was a sick thud when he hit the concrete.
This isn't where Rob Van Dam wants to be.
Rob Van Dam looking to capitalize.
In recent weeks, King, we've seen some type of relationship forming between Ric Flair and Batista. What do you make of it?
Well, I'm not really sure what's going on there. Flair essentially told Batista earlier tonight that he hadn't seen anybody with as much potential as he has in a long, long time.
And moments later, Batista went on to make quick work of the Hurricane.
Well, you gotta wonder what Batista could become under the tutelage of Ric Flair and potentially even the Nature Boy's best friend, Triple H. Luthes press.
Rob Van Dam turns it around.
Yeah, not so fast.
Struggling for control.
Triple H is taking complete and total control of this match. Boy, he was able to reverse and get out of that.
RVD avoiding danger there.
Well, that could have been... Look out!
Triple H trying to make it to Armageddon and hoping to add to his already impressive resume that includes one World Heavyweight Championship reign and five WWE title reigns.
Well, let's not forget the Intercontinental, European, and Tag Team Championships, as well as the King of the Ring and Royal Rumble wins. Man, this rivalry between Triple H and Shawn Michaels goes well beyond wins and losses. The game is hell-bent on making HBK's life a living hell.
And ironically, before this match started, Michaels told Triple H that as long as he has the World Heavyweight Championship, it's the game's life that will be a living hell.
Well, it's hard to argue that. Triple H lives for the World Heavyweight Championship. With every fiber of his being, he wants nothing more than to recapture the gold. You know, it seems as though both Rob Van Dam and Shawn Michaels have had Triple H's number of late.
I think it's eating Triple H up with jealousy as it relates to Shawn Michaels. Triple H lost to Michaels at SummerSlam in a street fight. Then he lost to Michaels at Survivor Series in the Elimination Chamber. The same night that HBK became World Heavyweight Champion.
Well, I don't know if it's jealousy or anger or what it is, but I do know that Triple H will stop at nothing to regain the World Heavyweight Championship. And that's bad news for Rob Van Dam and Shawn Michaels. Oh, tomorrow marks the 11th anniversary of Hulk Hogan defeating Undertaker for the WWE Championship at the Tuesday in Texas pay-per-view.
Now that's relevant here, folks, because the controversy surrounding that win led to then WWE President Jack Tunney vacating the title, which was then won by none other than Ric Flair.
Oh man, 11 years later, and the Nature Boy is still a major force in the championship picture. This time, alongside the game, Triple H.
And of course, Flair's win came at the 1992 Royal Rumble. It marked his first of two memorable WWE Championship reigns for the Nature Boy.
Oh, wow, here he comes. Now this is a comeback. And listen to this crowd. Whoa. Does he have his eyes open?
I don't know how Shawn Michaels is going to be impartial here tonight after what Triple H did to him last week with that backbreak onto the steel chair.
Oh, I agree, Cole. Michaels could snap at any moment and cost himself the World Heavyweight Championship.
And then the biggest question remaining is what would happen to the World Heavyweight Championship match at Armageddon? Hopefully, we won't have to worry about that, but I wouldn't be shocked if we did.
Oh, wait, nice reversal.
And he gets back in the ring.
Well, this isn't where Rob Van Dam wants to be, I can assure you of that. You know, Cole, I don't think think Rob Van Dam has ever forgotten the role Triple H played in RVD losing the Intercontinental Championship to Chris Jericho just a few short months ago?
You might be right, King. It was Triple H's interference that ultimately distracted Van Dam long enough for him to fall victim to Y2J and lose the title.
He saw that one coming.
Heads up! Surprised me if Eric Bischoff came out here and stripped Shawn Michaels.
Triple H with the cover on Rob Van Dam, and there's Shawn Michaels. And oh man, Triple H is not gonna like that, King.
You think that was a little slow?
You think?
The game is living.
And now Rob Van Dam rolling up Triple H. And
a really fast count from Shawn Michaels now on the game. DDT. And he reversed it. Good move.
And Triple H hits the ground.
Today, too fast.
Oh, look at RVD. Here's a reversal. He whips Triple H into the corner. What's RVD going to do here? Oh, big shoulder block.
Right to the gut.
And another. Look at this. Oh, Triple H with the close up. Oh, they both ducked. And now RVD off the ropes onto HBK. Woohoo, a jumping corner splash. Now what? Turning it around. It's Rob Van Dam with the reversal.
Under the ring, but this isn't a no disqualification match.
He might be trying to get disqualified.
Oh, and did you hear the impact? Oh, and he gets cracked again with that steel chair.
The steel chair shots continue. Timber, and he falls hard.
Again, this isn't a no disqualification match. Anything that comes out from under that ring could cost him the match.
What a shot!
Wow! If he keeps this up, this could be over quick.
There's a cover.
Triple H doing a great job of turning that around.
And we're going back between the ropes.
That landed like a ton of bricks.
And he dodges that one. Now back to the ring.
Oh, no. Oh, my gosh. I thought he was going to get leveled there. And Rob Van Dam is on very wobbly legs.
And this is going to return to the ring.
Van Dam plans on gaining some altitude here.
Oh my gosh!
He's going for the pin! This could be it!
Dodges to the side of that one.
Back into the ring now. What's he gonna do here?
Look, Rob Van Dam. He looks like he's got this.
Three. He may get the three count right here.
Turning it around, it's Rob.
And will this be it?
Triple H with a beautiful reversal.
Triple H knows how to polish off an opponent.
His shoulders are down.
Shawn Michaels hates that. But the game shoving it right in Michaels' face. One, two, three, and now what? Oh, look at this. Triple H demanding that Shawn Michaels raise the game's hand in victory. Here, I guess he's going to have to eat crow and do it.
Oh! No, he isn't. Michaels unloading on Triple H, and Triple H turning the tables. And another brawl is broken out between these two.
Oh, my gosh, the fists are flying. The game and Shawn Michaels going at it.
Emotions running so high between these two men. They can't stand each other.
Wow.
This has become so personal each and every week.
Well, they got here. Oh, big elbow off the rope then. Woo, the showstopper back to his feet.
And finally, some help out here.
Yeah, they're going to have to try.
Oh, sweet chin music.
Well, Triple H may have won this match, but he sure didn't win the fight.